Alright, this is the first warm-up set. It's a 20-pound bar with a 44 on each side, so 108 pounds. You can make fun of me if you want, but I have a mixture of old, like, cast iron plates from the 50s and 60s mixed with plastic weights, whatever. But in my opinion, weight is weight, so it really doesn't matter. But I just added 15 each side, so it's just 138 pounds. For those of you that haven't seen this before, to make a standard size bar work on an Olympic size bench, see, this is the actual inside collar that was, you know, made for the bar. What I did was I added a steel sleeve, and then I took a spin-on collar and made another inside collar, and that way it widened it up that much, and then it fits on the big wide bench. Alright, I added another pair of the 15-pound concrete filled weights, and I'm not putting those on there just because they look bigger. It's just like a really nice increment to jump on the early rounds, on the early sets, so I just like using the 15s. And then after I go past these a little bit, I'll grab some 25 pound cast iron plates and replace them, and then go from those out. So, but anyway, this is 168. Alright, I added another 10-pound vinyl weight to each side, so this is 188 pounds. As you can see, I'm starting to run out of room on the bar because of how thick those plastic weights are. So after this set, I'll probably start throwing some cast iron on there. And also, I might sound a little out of breath here and there, but that's because even when I start working out for the first time again and I'm out of shape, I still try not to pause very long between sets because I try to build up my aerobic fitness at the same time I'm building strength, so I don't take real long breaks in between or anything. I'm not overdoing it on the reps because I don't know how high I'm gonna go. Alright, this camera's dying, so I'm gonna go grab the Sony and I'll be right back. Alright, that last set was 188, and what I did, I peeled it all off, and then I put a 25-pound cast iron plate next to the 44. So we have a 44, a 25, a 15, and a 15. You can see the 15 on there. So now with the 20-pound bar, this is 218.
Too bad.
Alright, as you can see, I added the 10 pound vinyl weights to each side again. So this is 238. Too bad. Again, I'm not trying to push myself too hard, just trying to see where I'm at. Alright guys, I added a 10 pound cast iron weight to each side, so this is 258 pounds. That wasn't too bad. It's been a while. So I don't think I'm going to do any more tonight. That's enough that I can kind of test where I'm at since I'm just getting started. Obviously, I got a little more in me than that, but how much, I don't know. And I really don't want to push it unless I got a spotter standing behind me. So, alright guys, so that was 258 for a double. That's probably kind of funny to some of you that I have to sort of get psyched up to do 258, but I'm just getting started again. I had a few of you asking if I was still at the, you know, working out and everything. But honestly, I did it for a while, and then I got away from it for the last few months, and so I got really out of shape again. but I'm tired of being so heavy. So I got the treadmill in here. You know, we got the little weight room here. Kind of, it's not as good as our one above the garage, but we have a little weight room set up here right off the kitchen, so I really have no excuse not to lift. And I do have some goals for the bench press this year and the deadlift, so I'm going to try to hit those. And I won't show you all my workouts all the time, but I will try to post one every once in a while just to let you know where I'm at and if I'm progressing and everything. So anyway, hopefully you found it interesting, and we'll have a bunch more car videos coming your way soon, and I'll see you later. Bye.